Next up, our next speaker is Aidan Kestigian. He's a senior. He's a math and philosophy double major. If you haven't gotten a sense already, this is like the 10 nerdiest students at meeting. I think that's a proud thing, right? And she's going to be recruiting us for the Rick Santorum campaign. She's going to be talking to us about how we decide who runs this country. Anyone that followed the 2008 campaign, the current presidential campaign, knows how convoluted that process can be. And Aidan here is, she's here to explain to us that in fact it's much more complicated than we already think. So please welcome Aidan.
In the last example, voted for A, just, you know, so now only two people are voting for So in this case, clearly B and C will move on because, you know, they get more votes. So we've eliminated A. So, in the same kind of method as before, we look back at the table, we see that candidate B wins in the top two cases, so B gets 27 votes, and in the bottom case, C only gets 26 votes. So, B is the winner. Okay, so what does this tell us? Why am I just throwing all these tables at you? Well, in the first case, when the 27 people actually showed up to the polls, they got their last choice. They got candidate C, the person they really hate. But when they decided to stay home, they got their second choice. They got B. So in this case, those 47 people, nearly half of the voters, were better off not going to the polls at all. So, I mean, clearly this is like a really big problem. because we want people to, you know, have incentive to vote, and we want their votes to actually help the candidates that they like, not hurt them. And I just want to take a second to note that, you know, I'm trying to relate these runoff elections to the presidential primaries. And we don't even have this, because when we vote, we have this weird, like, split first stage where only Democrats can vote for Democrats and only Republicans can vote for Republicans. So, like, this complexity is, like, not even where we're at. We're even So, anyway, so this is a paradox, right? But it's a structural paradox, which means that it's really unavoidable. We can't fix it. And unfortunately, this is true kind of all voting systems. There's actually a very famous theorem in voting theory which says that essentially there is no voting system that is both paradox-free and not a dictatorship. So either you've got a dictator or these things can happen. So obviously this is a problem, but the best we can do is try to make our elections fair and have these paradoxes occur as infrequently as possible. But I claim that even beyond these structural problems, we make matters worse for ourselves in the way that we actually conduct our primaries. So primaries are used to divide delegates among the available candidates. among the available candidates so that a winner can be determined at the national convention. And we do this in two ways. So the Democratic Party usually uses a proportional method in which a candidate receives the number of delegates proportional to the percentage of the vote won by that candidate. So essentially all that means is if you win 40% of the vote, you should get 40% of the candidates. But we also have this winner-take-all method in which the individual who wins the most votes in a state gets all of that state's delegates. So I'm just going to go through a couple examples and show why this kind of really matters. So let's consider the Republican race in 2008. So as Aidan just said, you know, 2008, kind of a mess. But the Republican Party was surprisingly, you know, their primaries were pretty short. And that's because John McCain won a lot of the early primaries, and because the Republican Party used the winner-take-all method, McCain won all of the delegates from those states, so he sealed the nomination, like, really early on. The Democrats, however, not the case. So the Democrats used, and still use, a proportional method for dividing delegates from candidates. And this led to a long, drawn-out, really largely indecisive primary season for the Democratic Party. And that's because Clinton and Obama, in many cases, won close to half of the vote in each state, which means that they split delegates in most of the contested states. So there really was no, like, big winner. Now, it might seem like these are just kind of two methods of arriving at the same result. Because, I mean, it seems like if you win, you know, most of the vote, you're going to get most of the delegates, then you'll be the winner in another case. But actually, that is just not true at all, and I'll show you why. So let's look at the Democratic race in 2008. So going into the convention, as it stood, what actually happened was Obama was leading Clinton by just over 100 pledged delegates. I'm talking only about delegates who had to be for that candidate. But if the Democrats had used the Republican method, the winner-take-all method, Clinton would have been leading Obama by nearly 500 pledged delegates going to the convention, which, I mean, if you follow this stuff at all, that's huge. That's just crazy. So clearly, the way that we count these things really does matter. Okay, so now let's look at what we're dealing with right now. So the 2012 Republican primary. So this year, the Republican primary has changed their rules. The change in their convention rules is about this big. But they changed to mostly proportional primaries prior to an April 1st deadline. So they're kind of switching it up, seeing what happens. But so let's consider what happened if they hadn't made this change. So if the Republicans had kept with their winner-take-all method, Romney would have nearly three times the number of delegates that Santorum has right now. And yet, you know, we hear on the news every day how much Santorum is gaining speed. I guess this is my, you know, recruiting you. But so my point in all this is that there are these structural and unavoidable deficiencies with the way that we've decided to hold our elections. But on top of these deficiencies, you know, the particular ways in which we conduct our primaries have a colossal effect on the election outcome. And as informed voters, I think, you know, we should all be aware of that when we go to the polls.